Let me take this off. Welcome, beautiful people, back to our channel.
Today's a fun topic.
Today is a topic a bit different because I felt like after some recent events in my life that I would have to come on here and give you a little bit of a heads up on dating in Korea.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of people have come on our page and send us DMs and they ask questions like, so how's dating in Korea? How are the boys? Are they are nice and is the drama? Obviously, the answer is no.
They are not my drama.
Everybody
people.
Knows that. But I'm gonna tell you a bit of a story that will, I hope,
fun.
Yes, that will, I hope, serve as a cautionary tale for all these girls that are new in Korea. And especially if you are a girl of color, this will also help you because I think there is like slight differences depending on like what country you came from, etc., and like your expectations. One thing that you need to remember is that nice guys are probably the most dangerous guys on this planet. Like literally people who claim themselves to be nice guys
are beware
the worst.
No, I don't think they are the worst, but like
no, the ones who claim they have to say they're nice guys.
Yeah.
But anyway, it's fine, it's fine. We don't have to rant here. Nobody's angry. Everybody's fine.
It's fine. Water,
water under the bridge.
Fine, it's fine.
So basically, yeah, people were asking how dating in Korea is, differences with Tinder, etc. I'm not on Tinder anymore. And as a disclaimer, I am in a loving relationship. And I'm also not here to bash men in this country or anything like that. I'm here to bash men in general. I'm just kidding, but I'm not here to bash Korean men. I'm just saying, in my experience,
yeah, what happened to
what
you?
Has happened more than often and like more than a comfortable number of times, mm-hmm. right? And I'm not necessarily a naive person. I will give the benefit of the doubt to people, but like I'm still kind of smart. So certain things happen, and I'm like, okay, I'm not stupid. You're just an asshole. I have two stories, and Leslie were there. Was like first.
I think I was there. Yeah.
First raw.
So both of them, I was there. So
absolutely. Yes. So I'm gonna get started. You'll see why you have to really be careful, and I will tell you why at the end.
You have to be careful at all times. That's so sad.
No,
that's so sad.
You have to be
you
super
never
careful.
Safe. Anyway,
if you're the type that gives the benefit of the doubt to people, take that benefit back, please, and put it in your pocket because
we don't have time for this. We're tired.
We don't have time. We don't have time. Anyway, so
story one.
Story number one.
How do we call the guy?
Oh my god, how do we call him? We're gonna call him Kevin.
Kevin!
So it started as like what could have been a really romantic story. It was cute. And then it turned into like, I don't really know.
Nah.
So the first time we were in Korea on vacation. So that was like 2017.
Yeah.
And we were just on the subway going somewhere. And this random guy who has been looking at us for a while came up to us, and I'm like, oh gosh, what? And he comes up to us with his phone, and I'm like, oh, he's not saying anything. And he gives us his phone, and he has a Google translated text that says, hi, I'm really nervous because I'm not good at English, something like this. Mm. He's like, I really can't speak to you in English, but I would really like to be friends with you guys.
That's adorable.
Yeah, so now in retrospect, I'm like, yeah, no, that's kind of...
No, that's cute.
Somebody who doesn't know you, why would I want to be friends with you?
No, that's just a pickup line, whatever, but that's a cute way to approach.
Yeah,
you're
I
like,
guess.
You're so beautiful, I want to pass away from the language barrier, I want to learn English. But yo, how cute
that's
is that?
That's what we thought, that's what we thought. We're like, oh, that's so cute, so
adorable.
Sweet. Okay, cool. So we were like, we're sorry, but we're literally leaving tomorrow.
Yeah,
we were leaving
yeah.
tomorrow, we're back to friends. So we were like, oh, but we have Instagram. So we exchanged Instagram, followed him and everything. And then I left. Fast forward a year later, he never spoke to me, never DM me, never did anything. So I was like, okay, cool, whatever. In the meantime, we had decided to move to Korea full time. And literally 2 days before we get on the plane, I called you. I was like, what the hell? This guy DM'd me like, hey, how have you been?
Out of the blue. What?
How did you sense that we were on our way back to you, darling? How? I don't understand still. But anyway, he DM'd me. I was like, wow, like destiny, right?
Yeah, so cute. Like the whole thing is like a movie.
I'm like, how did you? I'm like, dude, what? We're coming back to Korea in like 2 days. How did you know? He's like, wow, are you serious? And he still didn't speak very good English, but his English was somehow better because we could speak. I didn't know any Korean. And so, yeah, I'm like, okay, so when we come, we have to see each other, da da da. Me, I'm like, this guy's cool. Like, No problem. Mm-hmm. I'm like, yeah. And we did. We met. You were there.
We met a couple of times. The guy was fun too. Like, we went to a night market on Hangang. We had a great night. It was cool. It was at the time when we could actually do stuff outside. So it was very nice.
We went to the river. And then the second time we met to go eat somewhere.
In Hongdae, then we went to karaoke.
And remember when we had the hangover soup? Even at the end of Hongdae, and he was like cutting the meat.
So we spent the whole night.
Yeah, we spent the whole night with the guy and other people, with him. But we spent the whole night with him until like what, 6 a.m. or something.
Did we go out in the club with him?
I don't remember if we went to a club, but we went drinking.
Otherwise, how did we spend the
whole night? Probably just a pota, maybe.
I don't remember seeing him dance.
Yeah, I don't remember seeing. Oh no, I think we went to a club with him, and he was just kind of standing there awkwardly.
Was it the aura?
Oh, it could have been. But anyway, we went out all night for sure. And then
it was a fun night too.
Yeah. So we have fun with this guy. And then I think I saw him again on another occasion or whatever. And then we met him with two of his friends. I don't remember where that was, honestly. But we have the picture with his two friends.
No, I remember where it was.
When we met them all three?
Yeah.
Because I really remember when we met the friends after.
We had dinner with the friends. We had drinks with the friends.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then, I don't know what happened between those two events, but I know for sure that we had a conversation on the phone. And he was kind of like, we were texting all the time and calling. Literally, we would call like probably every night for like a few days.
I think so, yeah.
And then he was just like, yeah, like, I just want to tell you, like, I like you very much. And I don't remember if he dropped the L-bomb or what, but I know he was saying like really like deep things. And I was like, you know, we just met. Like, I don't really know. Like, I mean, I like you too, but you know, let's just take things easy,
like,
right?
Slow. Let's take it slow.
Yeah. And then for some reason, his friends contacted me. Like, not him, just his friend. And they're like, hey, we would love to take you guys out for dinner. And I'm like,
ah, yeah.
Well, that's weird.
That's really weird.
But we didn't know anybody. We only knew people from school, I think, or whatever.
Not even. And school, you didn't even really
Or
start.
Maybe the... Yeah, we didn't... We had, like, just a couple of friends. Yeah, not yeah, even. Yeah. So we were like, okay, cool. So I went with her again.
Hey.
So it was just four of us. It was four
that
of us.
That would be weird.
Two guys, us two, and they just started bashing him. Like, wait, so why... What do you say in him again? Remember, we were like, these guys are kind of low-key assholes.
Yeah.
Because we thought they were joking, and then they were real... No, seriously.
Yeah.
Are you really into him? He's so
what
ugly.
What kind of friendship is that?
Yeah, he was like, he can't speak English. He's so ugly. Why are you talking to him? That's so weird. I was like, are you guys his friends for real? What's going on?
Yeah, what's the end game here? Reverse psychology or what is going on?
Yeah,
here?
Because, we thought he was trying to test us. Yeah. And so I'm like, that's weird. And literally, we even got annoyed at some point because they did it the whole dinner and dessert. We went to a cafe for dessert and they were like, okay, but seriously, tell us the truth. Did he, like, what happened? Like, what do you like him?
Jesus Christ. What a friend.
I remember where I met them. The guy in the kimono at his birthday party. The guy invited me as his date.
Yeah. Now, you had the contact of the guy, of the kimono guy?
Yes. 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 And this is why, and this is where the shit gets a little crazy.
Oh, yeah.
You know what pissed me off? You know what pissed me off at that moment? Now I remember exactly what started to piss me off. I went to the birthday party as his plus one.
Uh-huh.
And they were all waiting at a cafe before going at like a meat restaurant or whatever. I walked in and everybody was like obviously shocked. I don't know why, but everybody looked at me really like, oh, okay. And I was like, oh, hi. And I knew a little bit of Korean at that moment. So I introduced myself in Korean. So I was like, oh my God, da-da-da-da. And he was kind of treating me like I was with him, like kind of. Because I was his plus one.
Mm.
And he told me over the phone, he was like, yeah, you know, like, I really, really like black girls. That's when I was like,
oh, we're going there.
Okay. And you know what happened? Before that birthday party, he had asked me to come there. And I was like, you know what? I don't know if it's appropriate. I don't really know your friends and whatnot. And he insisted for like 3 days straight. And when we went out to drink, he took me outside and he was like, hey, but are you sure you can't come to the party? That's what it was. Because he wanted me to come by force.
Yeah. And then we were like, maybe he just wanted to present you to the friend.
Exactly. So I was like, so you're just trying to like show me off, like, hey, I have a black girl on my arm, da 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 da. That's what it was.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's how we knew the friend, and we saw him again, and like, what do you like about him?
Oh my God, yes, it all comes back. Okay.
So after that happened, and the whole comment about liking only black girls or only foreigners, he said something about foreigners and black girls. So I was just like, okay, that giving fetishism, but yeah. Okay. And then the incident with his friend who kept testing us, I was like, okay, that's kind of like weird. I don't know if you're sending your friends to like try to test me and see if I like you or whatever, if I'm lying to you, but I don't like it. So I kind of like started regressing back to like, okay, just do your thing. Like, I don't really want to talk to you. And then I stopped seeing him like face to face, but we kept texting. And then one day he's like, hey, I really want us to go like out for dinner. I'm like, I don't know. Okay, I will let you know when I'm free. And then he calls me another day when I'm home and I'm sick that day. I was in the Gochiwan and I was in my room all day. I was sick. I had like a fever or whatever. I was not feeling well. This guy calls me and he's like, yeah, so how about we meet today, tonight? And I'm like, sorry, I'm not feeling well today, which was not a lie.
True.
I just need to just be at home right now. I don't really want to go out. He's like, oh, okay. And then a few minutes later, he's like, yeah, I'm at the station near your house.
Oh.
I bought medicine. Can you at least come out so I can see you?
That's cute in itself.
When it's cute, but
independently, that's cute.
I did not tell you my address.
Yeah, that's not cute.
How do you know what my station is?
No, the station I think knows because we were in Hongdae all the time.
So?
No, matter.
If we were in Hongdae, he could have gone to Hongdae, Hapdong, and Sinchon.
I think we probably said we live in Sinchon.
I don't remember telling where probably. I live.
No, not exactly where, but in Sinchon area.
So I'm just like, okay, well, I didn't tell you where I left, so why, how? I told him this. I was like, why are you in my area? Like, how do you know where I'm at? Yeah. He's like, no, just come out. And I'm like, what? What do you mean? I don't feel good. I'm like really in bed right now. And he literally kept calling me for an hour straight.
That's
I even remember suspect. Falling asleep because I was like taking a nap. I was so, and I woke up, he was like, I'm still there.
See,
so I'm like, okay, am I an asshole or am I terrified? Because I'm not trying to go see you and like you're not taking no for an answer, and I'm not gonna go out in a country I don't know and go see you and I don't know what you're gonna do. I'm like,
I mean, it's supposed, like, in a movie, that would be cute. That would be cute behavior. That would be romantic behavior. But in itself, when you think about it, I told you no. You should listen to me.
Just leave and we can meet another time.
Like, don't stay here. If I told you already it's no, that's it. That's my answer. Why are you suffering by yourself in the street? I told you no.
So between that and the people's, his friend's weird behavior, we still don't know why they were acting
tokenism,
like this. And then the token, like, foreign girl, da da da, and like, really, really insisting, like literally over like 3 days, insisting that I come to a party with you. I was like,
good match.
And this is giving obsessed.
Yeah,
and so I'm gonna have to block you.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. I hope he's doing well these days.
Probably.
And I hope he's a bit more willing to understand,
that's not cute.
That was not cute.
So bad because it started so well.
Yeah,
like
it started
the whole
really
romantic
well.
Story and then bam.
I don't know. So at that point, I'm still like, yeah, you know, it's just, you know, he was just a little clingy maybe, I don't know. He's not a bad guy. What I thought, right? So I'm not like writing them out yet. I'm still naive. I'm like, oh, I want a date, da da da. So fast forward a couple months later.
Not that long now.
Not even that long. Let's rewind, actually, to before we were in Korea, right?
That's story two. Let's go.
That's story number two. This story is like getting kind of long, so I don't want the video to be super long. So we will find you in part two of this video coming right up. See you
next time.
Next time, you'll see us. So yeah, if you want to hear the rest of this story, check us out.
Put on the alarm, then you will know when it will be out, because we don't know yet, so.
Yeah. Like and subscribe while you're at it, because, you know, it's free.
Why not?
And we'll see you in the next video.
Bye.